So how to deal with a Scorpio that is very controlling? Now, there are personalities that have a tendency towards different structures. And a Scorpio has a tendency to develop a controlling personality and a personality that places a lot of tests on other people, now man or woman. And as I've gotten a lot of questions through email coaching and Instagram DMs, I see a pattern that comes up. Now, dealing with these people can be very difficult, and it takes a lot of patience. But really dealing with them is understanding another person at the core. So if you're in a relationship with someone and they have some controlling tendencies, or they seem to put you through a lot of tests, what is it that caused this personality structure to develop? Because it's definitely not their personality, right? You can feel that these people have love for you, and you can feel that these people want the best for you, yet they don't know how to open up truly. The first thing to understand is that the Scorpio personality, due to the energy bodies, it comes in this planet through a fixed nature. So it comes, one, with a fixed nature, two, a highly emotional nature, and three, one that does not like to change. So they are highly emotional, they do not like change, and they are very, very sexual and dominant in terms of willpower. So they're very stubborn people. Now, if you understand that the energy of Mars, the energy of Pluto, it causes them to function at a... it gives them quite the erotic flavor, and it also gives them the energy of transformation, meaning it can attract many situations to them. These Scorpios function on a high, extreme, and intense frequency, very extreme. So many times they will attract extreme situations to them. With this comes, you know, the world is not perfect. Extreme situations of betrayal, extreme situations of heartbreak, and extreme situations of, you know, just unfortunate events that happen to them in life. And this causes their personality to become closed off many times. And it is a coping mechanism that many Scorpios are prone to developing. I do say prone, right? Prone to developing a very controlling behavior, or a behavior that makes them test their partner. So they have to understand that their nature is fixed and it is prone to develop these things. So how would you develop them? Or excuse me, how would you deal with these people? It is to understand that the person you are dealing with is not really that person. The Scorpio's outer facade, the outer face, is usually a coping mechanism, right? And what's underneath this? What is underneath the control? And what is underneath the test? Really, it is fear. Many times Scorpios will want to control you because they have a fear of being betrayed. And many times they will want to test you because they are insecure that you may leave them and betray them. All right, these are counterfeit, what we can call counterfeit personalities. So if you see this happening with you, if you're a Scorpio, or your partner, or someone in your life who's a Scorpio, this is a deep thing to understand, that they might not even be aware of what they're doing due to, one, emotional overload, two, a fixed nature, and three, fear of vulnerability, right? Who they are on the surface, who they are on the core, is not the same person. And it's very tough for these people to see from the outside in. And someone messaged me on Instagram, she said, "Can you turn Healing a Scorpio, one of my audiobooks, into a physical book? I would like to give it to a Scorpio who I think has great potential," something like that. So that's going to be on paperback soon. I would highly recommend that for people who know these type of people who are so damaged and closed off. It's Healing a Scorpio, we go into that. But that Healing a Scorpio is more on a general term, on a clearing the Scorpio's deep, dark, subconscious traumas and energies, right? But in many cases, this is a case-by-case basis. If you're not Scorpio, what would I recommend you? What would I recommend you to tell them? That it's okay to let your guard down, Mr. and Mrs. Scorpio. And it's okay to trust. When you develop this persona, you are oftentimes running away from the real you. And the real you desires intimacy, and the real you desires love, and the real you desires closeness in relationships. And because they feel so deeply, and because they get wounded so deeply, they may never ever want to trust again. But in the depths and in the throes of love, love is something that goes beyond. And love is something that fights through the pain and through the trauma, because it wants a vehicle to express itself. And you yourself are a vehicle for this expression. But many times, what can trigger these personality structures to arise, especially in the Scorpio, is one, it is betrayal from perhaps their mother or their father, the opposite sex partner. And two, it is a wound from past heartbreak, which then causes them to ration out their love, and which then causes them to test their partner and to control their partner because they have a fear of vulnerability and that happening again. They say, I need to control this person. I need to have this power over this person because I saw this when I was younger. They might not even know it. To share and to trust will automatically shift the vibration of a person who is stuck in this fixed nature. And it will open up their minds into new ideas. So how to deal with these people is first to understand them. And you can always let them know, hey, look, I know you think this. I know X, Y, and Z happened to you. I know maybe you got betrayed in the past. But I'm not going to do that to you. I'm not the one that's going to do that to you. And if you went through some issues in the past, or if you went through some things that caused you to lose out on relationships and you're not able to get close to people anymore, hey, I'm not going to do that to you. And these behavior patterns will become exposed. Maybe send them this video. Send them Helios Scorpio when we got on paperback. I would highly recommend that. Because it is such a shame for us to fall victim to our own nature. And it is such a shame to hold on to energies and traumas and wounds of the past. We all have messed up experiences. Excuse my language. We all have fucked up experiences in life. But there are times where we develop defense mechanisms and coping mechanisms that will cause us to self-sabotage our own relationships. And the only thing that can really fix these things is love, is self-understanding, self-introspection, the expansion of our own consciousness. How to deal with these people? So let them know, look, whatever happened to you in the past, if you have some things you need to work through, you constantly ghost and you constantly do these things. So I'm not going to do these things to you. I'm not going to hurt you. I'm not here to hurt you. I'm not here to treat you wrong. And it may take them a while to open up. It may take them a while to trust again. However, you doing this will be a catalyst for their own evolution. And if you are a person, if you are a very controlling person, if you are someone who puts their lover through a bunch of tests, these girls through a bunch of tests, these guys through a bunch of tests, and you find yourself alone at the end of the day, maybe you have to look at yourself in the mirror and see, am I just playing too many games? Am I making people jump through too many hoops? Why? Because I've been betrayed in the past, because I've been hurt in the past, because things have not worked out for me, so I am unconsciously pushing them away? Do I truly trust people? Those are the things you want to ask yourself. I understand as a Scorpio, it's tough to let shit go. But if you can't let the shit of the past go, how are you gonna welcome the shit of the future, right? Maybe it's time you take a look in the mirror. If you are someone that is dealing with a Scorpio's test or somebody's test, if we're going to be ghosting, or if you are the one that is ghosting, shutting people off and cutting people off too fast, even almost looking for a reason to cut them off, is that healthy for you? Is this the love that you want? If you can look around in your life right now, is this really what you desire? We all got our own demons to deal with. Hurt people, healed people, healed people. 7 keys to healing a Scorpio, become an evolved Scorpio. Get that in the description. Coming to Amazon soon. Thanks for whoever recommended it.
Hey, what's up? It's your man, Master J. Are you on your spiritual journey? Perhaps you're dealing with a twin flame runner chaser dynamic, or you have a soul purpose that you want to live out. You don't want to keep staying in the matrix 9-to-5 system. It's starting to wear on your soul. As we know, the system is collapsing. As things are collapsing and new age consciousness is rising, there are groups of people connecting throughout the world. So I would personally like to invite you to Scorpio Scriptures Inner Circle. Our inner circle is composed of me, 4 of my disciples, actually 5 now, and people just like you on your journey. We talk about twin flame journey, healing, all the secrets of the universe in between this and that, how to create something that you enjoy, a network, a system, a business, a sole purpose, just based around you. So if you are interested in something like this, changing your life, manifesting a new life, you're tired of everything, you're feeling the shift, you're ready to arise in consciousness and really live out your destiny, I would like to invite you, check out ScorpioScriptures.com/MasterJ. You can find the link in the description to learn more. What it's going to take you to is just an application so we can see what you're all about. After that, me and my team will go over it and send you a message on how to proceed further. If you don't get in the first time, it's okay. It's not for everybody. We are very, very picky about who we let in, who we talk to, because in the book, Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich, he says, when two or more minds come together, a third mind is formed called a mastermind. We just want people who are on a like-minded wavelength and the same journey to get along. So no hard feelings. We'll see you on the other side. I hope to see all of you there that are meant to be there. And in the future, we can meet up just like this as we do work together, changing the world, changing your world. See you then.